Hi everyone, I'm Elsabe from Schuurfer Design South Africa. On my YouTube channel, Sew Stylish with Elsabe, I just enjoy sharing my sewing tips and techniques for garment sewing. Now today I'm going to talk to you a little bit about pattern fitting and specifically the change we need to do to our sleeve cap if we have a forward shoulder. Now how do we identify that forward shoulder? If you have a look at the photo I'm sharing with you, now this is of my forward shoulder because I have quite an extreme forward shoulder, you are going to see that the seam at the shoulder point is angled to the back. Now in order to correct that, I have to move that seam at the shoulder point to the front without changing the seam at my neck point. Now what I'm going to show you today is really based on my measurements. You've got to make sure on your body that you work with your measurements if you do this change. One thing that I usually do when I help my customers that come for one-on-one pattern fitting with me is when they have their sloper on and we can see that seam pulling backwards, I like to put my hand on their shoulder and I put my thumb on this forward protruding bone and then my middle finger I actually put on this bone on the back of my shoulder, and my finger here I just go to the center and I would go and make a mark on this sloper so that we can go and measure where the seam line is and then where we have to take it to. Now mine is a 1.5 centimeter adjustment that I have to do, which is really quite extreme. So I'm just going to show you on my pattern pieces here what it looks like when we've done the adjustment on the bodice section. Here I've got my front and my back bodice that I've drafted from my Schuurfer Designs dress kit. I've already gone and done the lines for the adjustment, so I'm just going to talk you through this. If we look at the back bodice, this is my original shoulder point of my pattern. On the front, that is my original shoulder point. Now, when we are doing any changes to our patterns, we've got to remember that we have to keep this pattern balanced. If I am going to be adding on onto my armhole, I'll be taking off onto the armhole. If I don't do that, that means that my cap that I have is not going to be balanced when I'm sewing it onto my garment. Now, if we also look at my back bodice, my original armhole measures at 23.5 centimeters and my original front armhole measures at 21 centimeters. So that gives me, if I add it up, 44.5 centimeters. So after I do my adjustment and I go and measure my pattern piece, I still have to sit with that 44.5 centimeter for the armhole. That means that it's still balanced and it's still going to work with my length of my sleeve cap that I have. Now let's look at the adjustment that I've done. Here you can see that is my original shoulder point on my pattern pieces. Now, like I mentioned, what we have to do with a forward shoulder, the shoulder line must actually move to the front so that it sits on the correct position on my body. It's got to sit in the center of my shoulder. And then again, if we look on the front part, there's my original shoulder point. I've got to move this forward. So it is really just an angle change that I'm going to do. And please note that I am not making any changes on that neck point. For a forward shoulder, the adjustment is just on that shoulder point that we're going to work. Now on the back pattern, because this line has got to move forward, I will go and I add on my 1.5 centimeters that I need to add. So that literally goes and it increases my armhole length with 1.5 centimeters. If we look at the front, I've got to move this also to the front of my body. So that means I'm going to shift this shoulder seam line to the front. And in effect, I'm actually minusing my 1.5 centimeters on that armhole measurement that I have. When I go back and I do the whole measurement again to the new shoulder point and to my new shoulder point, I will still have my 44.5 centimeters, meaning that my sleeve cap length is still balanced to my armhole. So one thing that I did want to show you as well while I'm working on my pattern, all I'm going to do is I'm going to extend that shoulder or that armhole line into the new shoulder point. Something that I always do as well, I go and make sure that my original shoulder measurement, which is 12 centimeters, will still be 12 centimeters when I've done that 1.5 centimeter adjustment. Now I've already measured mine and I know that it is still the same. So I am going to go, and you can see it's just a slight change on that point that I'm getting there. So I'm just going to take this back into my armhole. On the front as well, it's just come in just a tiny bit. Now if you are just doing a small adjustment, you might not even find that your shoulder seam length changes, but on mine, because it is such a big change, and I always do get a slight change on that area. And that is really all we have to do on our bodice piece. The work really comes to the sleeve cap, because remember, when we look at our sleeve pattern, where that notch is, that notch always gets lined up when we pin onto where our original shoulder point was. So I've got to go and move this section now so that it actually works with my new shoulder point. Now, one thing that you might think is, okay, that is very easy. I'm just going to take my notch, I'll measure 1.5 centimeters, and I'll move it forward. That doesn't work. This whole sleeve cap needs to move forward to actually now work with my forward shoulder position. So how am I going to do that? Now this method I'm showing you is something I started doing last year. In my pattern making basics course on my Shoe Fit Academy, I actually show another way, and that works if we are working with a slight change. But I found with this extreme changes, 1 centimeter and more, that this method I'm going to show you now actually works better. And when I went and worked with Glenda for a couple of months last year in the US, we did do this change to some of her customers as well, and every time we got such a good fitting sleeve on the cap section. So what are we going to do this change now? First off, you'll notice that I have drawn a line going from underarm point to underarm point, and then I want you to go and you are going to extend your grain line for me. And I'm just going to extend it a little bit. Because why I want to extend it, I want to show you what happens when we do the shift. The other thing that I'm now going to do, because I want to move this whole cap forward and not just do a bit of a shift, which was my other method that I'm doing, I'm going to measure on this line from underarm to underarm, I'm going to measure my 1.5 centimeters to that, to the front. And you'll see I've measured, or I've marked back and front, so that you know that this is my back pattern, this is part of my front pattern. Now I'm working on my board with my line so that it is more accurate for me as well, but I'm going to go in and I measure my 1.5 centimeters in, and you can see I'm just making a slight line for myself. Now the next step that I'm going to do, I'm going to cut on this line that I've drawn so that I can move this whole pattern piece forward. Let me just remove my tape that I have here. So all I've got to do, because I'm moving forward, I'm taking this grain line and I'm shifting it forward the 1.5 centimeters. So that means that my grain line is going to match up with my 1.5 centimeter mark that I've done. And all I'm going to do, I just make sure I put everything back together again. And I just go and I tape this down. Now I've done a shift for this whole cap. Now if you look at where my shoulder point is and I bring it down, can you see how much it's moved forward? So that is correct. All I need to do now is I'm going to take this line, and this is my grain line, and I'm just going to extend it. So that is the change that I've done to move this shoulder point to the front. My next section that I've got to do is I'm going to extend this line. Remember, when we worked on our bodice, my armhole on the back got longer. So all I'm going to do, I'm just extending this, and I'm just going to pick it up from there. I'm just using this curve over there just to show you. So I am extending it. My bicep width, I still want to leave the same. I want to make sure that I'm not adjusting this bicep width. So all that's going to happen here now is that I'm going to go and I'm going to draw from the underarm point, and I'm just picking it up and I'm going back to my notch again. So I just put that back up there. So can you see how the front and the back has changed now? The bicep width is still the same. The only change I've made is to the cap. So in effect, what I've done with moving this forward, where I would usually get on my sleeve, and look at the photo again that I'm sharing, instead of getting all the extra fabric there on the back, I've actually shifted it, and now I'm actually having more fabric in the front to go over that prominent bone that I have on the front of my body. One other change that I then go and do to my pattern, because I've actually done a whole shift over here, is that on my front bodice and my back bodice, I just do a slight change. Remember, with a forward shoulder adjustment, the back of my body is actually curving slightly to the front, meaning that I need to just increase the width of my bodice on that armhole a little bit. And on the front, I'm just going to take off a little bit. If we look at the pattern again, and I'm just going back, by moving it forward, I've given more of the cap to the front, I've taken it on the back. So it's again a plus and a minus. I've plussed on the front a little bit, so I'm going to do this change by just minusing a little bit over there. On this area, I've actually taken it away from that back of my armhole on the cap, or let's say on my body. So I'm just going to go and I'm just going to add a little bit on that area so that I don't affect the width or the movement that I have across my back. Now, this will usually be about a quarter of an inch or a 6 millimeter change that I'm going to do. And it's usually on the across back. It's tiny. Sometimes I just eyeball it. I just want to give myself that little bit over there. So all I'm going to go and do now, let's grab this. I am just going to redraw and give myself a little bit of extra width on this area. And can you see when I'm doing it that way, I'm going back to my original or the shoulder point that I've already drawn in. And this is going to give me that extra that I need because of my back curving a little bit. If we look on the front now, whatever I've added there, I'm just going to go and just reduce it on this area. And that's going to prevent having all this excess fabric that we usually have on the front over there. So I'm just going to go and do that change. And I'm going to go to my new shoulder point. And I'm just going to draw that in. And here I'm going to have to move my stylus a little bit. So that is really the change that I've done. Whatever I've done over there, remember, for balanced patterns, we always go back and we do the needed changes over there. So that is really all you need to do if you've got a forward shoulder adjustment that you need to do on your patterns. But this is really just one of the ways that we can work with. This is one of the ways that I actually felt worked the best for my one-on-one customers that we did fitting with. So go and give this a go. Go try it and see if it works for you, if you need that forward shoulder adjustment. So that is our pattern fitting tip for today. You can go and join my newsletter. You can just email me at elsabe@surefordesigns.co.za and I'll add you to my newsletter for my South African customers. I've also got a WhatsApp group. I'm going to leave the link below for you as well. And make sure that you join my groups so that you can get updates on any of my new videos that I'm posting for you. So until next time, happy sewing.